About 5,000 New Yorkers worked on the Manhattan Project in Manhattan during the war. James Forde was hired by Union Carbide to work as a lab assistant at the Nash Garage building in New York City.
And I got laid off, and but I was eligible for unemployment insurance. So in those days, and I don't know what it's like now, you go to the unemployment insurance office and they could send you out on jobs that they thought you were qualified for. And they sent me to, I guess it was the Union Carbon and Carbide Company. They had an office in Midtown Manhattan. And I went there and they hired me and sent me to what turns out to be the Nash Garage on 132nd Street and Broadway. And that was the Manhattan Project.
After graduating from Howard University, George Warren Reed began working as a scientist at Columbia University's Substitute Alloy Materials Laboratory.
The chair of the chemistry department, white guy, was working on the SAM project, which, of course, we didn't know at the time was the atomic bomb project, in New York, at Columbia. There was another person, a man named Ed Russell, who's a black guy, who had come out to Chicago and he was working at the Met Lab. And I got in touch with them because I wanted to do chemistry if I could. But I was classified 1A, so I didn't know what was going to happen. And I was invited to come to New York and then to come to Chicago. Well, I went to New York and I was interviewed by a man named Simon Freed, who was a professor from the University of Chicago. Then I went on to Chicago. And when I got there, I was told, well, things were slowing down there and they weren't hiring. Well, I got a wire from New York saying, well, we can use you. So I went back to New York and I worked at Columbia first, and then we moved up on Broadway to a big old warehouse. And I worked there for, I don't know, a year and a half or something like that.